We just finished the C-Note show for today, and a man on there said, I was feeling great last month, but this month I'm feeling, you know, not great at all. I'm feeling in the dumps. I'm feeling like I'm drowning in the fear and the frustration and the concern and the anxiety around, am I doing the right thing, right? So last month was good, this month not so good. And he asked, was asking, am I delusional? Am I crazy? Was I just BSing myself 30 days ago and everything was really just off the rails then as well? Or what's going on? Cynthia Cruz is the only woman allowed on our show for her feminine professional perspective. I'm Mr. Jeff Allen. We coach men literally all around the world, one-on-one in our small groups. And we've got free stuff on our website as well. I'll tell you about that another time. But Cynthia, if a man asks, am I crazy, right? Like last month I was doing well. This month though, I'm not doing so well. I feel much more ungrounded. What would you say to that man? How would you have compassion for that man as a woman who sees men go through these phases, these chapters of this work? What would you say to bring some compassion for himself, please?
The path of the hero, that's what it makes me think of. And there is always this like cycle of the hero's journey that all of us are on, and the man's journey is different than the woman's journey. And when I watch a man and I feel the energy of a man who knows that every new challenge, every new cycle of growth, every new accomplishment, every new dragon face, that he is going to meet again parts of his old self along the way. And he doesn't disown that and is compassionate with all those pieces of himself. I, as a woman, feel in his presence that I can relax and I can trust whatever cycle he's on in his life, his kingdom that he's building, his trajectory that he's on, because he's not trying to push away the old parts of himself, and he's allowing them to come out into fruition and to do good things with his heroism and his kingship. I think anytime someone leads in that way, it demands incredible respect and honor. And that's how I feel in the presence of men who do that kind of work with this kind of perspective.
That's beautiful. That's beautiful. I'll give you a cherry on top that we talked about on today's show as well here in a second. If you haven't visited our website, we've got free stuff on there, a free 45-minute audiobook that Cynthia and I recorded, a free program as well, how to solve the number one cause of divorce, which is fear of divorce. So if you're getting in your own way, go check out our website, greatmenmovemountains.com. And if you want to reach out to me, reach out to us directly, fill out the contact form as well for the most powerful one-on-one, no BS consult with me that you've ever had with another man, I promise you. So a cherry on top here is, if you're getting in your own way, how to have compassion for yourself. One, go to other men, especially in our free Facebook group or other guys that you trust, and bounce how you're doing off of them. Okay. Number two, just dump it onto a piece of paper. And then if you want, shred the paper up and throw it away. That's fine. And number three, what am I grateful for right in this absolute moment? What can I bring into my life? And there's a lot of research, Stanford-backed research within this. So reach out to other men, bring love into your heart, even in a moment, right? And take the next step toward the kingly man that you want to be. Cynthia, thank you so much.
Hey, thank you.
Go move mountains one step at a time, guys.
Bye. Subscribe.
Want more affection, love, and sex in your marriage? Want less paralyzing fear and rejection? Join us live Monday to Friday Zoom call, men only, greatmenmovemountains.com/CNote. The C-Note Show, free daily call.
This I've got to see.
It's worth watching, so stay tuned.